Hello everyone. So this is our next video. In this I'll be telling you about the basics of cascading style sheet, that is CSS. So objectives for today's video will be link insertion. In the previous video, if you remember, in the description I mentioned that I will do link insertions, which is the topic of HTML in CSS video. So first we will cover that. After that I will introduce you to CSS and then other basic styling attributes which are used in CSS only. Now first, link insertion. In the previous video I taught you how to insert an image and link a website with that image. Okay, in this what we are going to do, we will link a website with the text. Here you can see, so A means anchor. I already told you about this in the previous video if you remember. H reference is hyperlink reference. URL will be the URL will be the URL of the website you want to link with the text. This is the text which will be linked with the website URL you are going to enter here. Okay, this is the closing tag. This is very easy, you know. I'll just show you it's working through an example. This is an example. In body tag I have mentioned this code. I've mentioned the website to be Google's homepage, and the text is hello, click here to open Google's homepage. So this is the output. Whenever the user clicks on this text, then the Google's homepage would be displayed, right? Now let's begin with introduction to CSS. Now first of all, the full form of CSS is cascading style sheets. CSS is basically used to style the web pages. You can also do this in HTML, but in HTML the styling is limited. In CSS you have complete advantages of the elements, complete access to them. You can use them with complete liberty. Okay, and in this font families you can use different font families, whatever you want to use. There's a wide range of font families and you can search this on internet wherever. And text alignment is there. You can align your text. I've already told you about this. Background image setting. See, in CSS you can also do background image setting. Okay, now in CSS you can set the color of your background. Okay, you can set an image as a background. You can make your text scrollable. You can literally do anything you want to do with your website to make it look attractive using CSS. It is completely for styling purpose. This is one example of CSS. This is the body. In body I have here mentioned heading, okay, h1. In this I have done inline styling for the heading. Okay, style under style tag, not tag, attribute, I have mentioned color to be white. So the color of my heading would be white and it will be in at the center of the site of the web page, and the text or heading is welcome. Okay, now styling of the body, that is my web page. In this what I have done, under the style tags I have mentioned background image URL as cobble.jpg. Now cobble is the name of the picture that I'm inserting as a background image, and .jpg is its extension. I already told you that whenever you want to insert an image you have to use JPG or PNG or GIF extensions. And background attachment is fixed. Now here this line, background attachment fixed, means that whenever the user scrolls the page, my image will remain still. Still means whether you go up, whether you or come down, image will be visible throughout the scrolling area. This is the output, and here you can see the background image is cobble. Okay, and this is my heading at the center, welcome, in white color. Next, we will talk about background attributes. Okay, now I have already told you about background image, right? If you want to insert an image as a background, then you can use this line. Here, URL. You have to mention URL as well, okay? In image, URL basically means the name of the picture along with its extensions. You can mention the background color as well. In this line, the color this. Here you will insert the value. For example, if I want the color of my web page, background color of my web page to be black, then what I'll do, I'll just write this line, add this line in this code, okay? Here you will put the value, that is, if I want the background color to be black, then I'll put black here. If I want it to be red, then you can write red here, any color. And also, you don't need to write the name of the color. You can also use the code, RGB code, that is red, green, blue code. Okay, and this RGB method, it basically uses. Next is background position. You can also set the background position you want. For example, if I want to insert an image at the top of my website or web page, right top of it, then I'll just simply put this line in the code and I will mention that at what position I want to insert that image, right? Because you can see in this line the position is right top, so the image would be inserted at the right side, right top, okay? And next is background attachment. Now, in previous example, here you can see that I told you that whether you scroll up or down, image will remain still. It means that this is the attachment is fixed. You can see here, see, background attachment is fixed, okay? I have already mentioned about this. If you don't want it to be fixed, then you can also, you know, put another value there. And one more thing I would like to include, that if you want to repeat images, for example, if you want your web page look like if you want to insert images as tiles, so you can use background repeat, and the values that would be passed in that code is repeat y if you want to repeat the image vertically, and x if you want to repeat the images horizontally. Okay, repeat x and repeat y would be the values for that. So this is all about this video. I know this video is a bit short, because CSS is basically it is a vast topic, but I am introducing only the basics of it right now, okay, in this course. So if you like this video, then don't forget to rate, share and review. In next video, I will introduce JavaScript. So thank you.